session of Academic World School Delhi. Now I am here to teach you biology. The chapter we have started is the fundamental unit of life. The fundamental unit of life is called cell. You are now aware about the cell concept, what is the cell theory, and how gradually we came to know about the cell, the people who have contributed the information related to cell. And in the last lecture, even I have discussed about the type of organism based on the number of cell, unicellular and multicellular. So in today's class, you will be learning about the cell type. That about the cell type means the organization, how it is, prokaryotes and eukaryotic cell, and then cell shape and size, structure of cell, how the cell is made up of, what are the content in it, and then about the cell membrane. So we will be covering all this thing. Coming to the organization of a cell, when we talk about the organization of cell, how the cell is, there are two different types of cell, prokaryotic cell. There is prokaryotic cell and there is eukaryotic cell. This is our first subtopic on the basis of organization. How the cell is organized. On that basis, the cells are of two different types, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. So I will be telling you about both type of cell. Now this term prokaryotic, here there is a word pro and then there is this karyotic word. So here the pro word, it means primitive, or I can say before, and karyon word, it means nucleus. Here the U word and karyotic, there are two words here. So the EU, it means true, and the karyon word, it means nucleus. So now you are aware about the term that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Prokaryotic cell means the cell which will be having the primitive nucleus, and there is the other kind of cell in the organism, that is eukaryotic, having true nucleus. Now these cells, before listing the points for this, I will try to explain you what is the major difference in these two types. It is a primitive cell, and this cell will be having the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. All the cell is having the cell membrane, and I told you that there is nucleus. In this case, the nucleus is not present like this. The nucleus is actually not having any kind of lining like how I made. The genetic material or the information, it is spread all around the cell. It means in the cytoplasm, these genetic material will be spread. And this type of nucleus is called nucleoid. This type of nucleus is called nucleoid, where nuclear membrane is not present. But in case of eukaryotic cell, means true nucleus or the advanced type of cell, in these type of cell, we can observe that there is a cell membrane having a nucleus, and this nucleus, this line what I have drawn, it's actually the nuclear membrane which is surrounding the nuclear region. Here the nucleic acid or the DNA, RNA is present over here, and the genetic material, it is confined only to the nucleus. It's not getting spread through the cytoplasm because there is nuclear membrane. membrane. This is nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane is present. So this nuclear membrane, what you can see here in the eukaryotic cell, this is covering complete the material which is inside the nucleus, right? So the inside material will be not spread outside, what I have told. And here this nucleoid, it is not membrane bound. Means no membrane is present in the nucleus of prokaryotic cell. This is the major difference. And apart from this, there are some other points which I will be listing you one by one. But you should have understood now that prokaryotic cell means primitive nucleus, means the cell having the primitive nucleus, and eukaryotic cell means a cell having a proper nucleus. This is the meaning of the term, what I have written. Now, in this, you have seen this is a very simple type of cell, and this is having a good membrane-bound nuclear material or nuclear region. So accordingly, there are certain characteristics of both, which I will be comparing and listing here to make you understand better. So the first thing, prokaryotic cell, the primitive cell, it is generally smaller in size. It is generally smaller in size. And the size, it may vary. You can write 1 to 10 micrometer. This is the value which is even written in your textbook, 1 to 10 micrometer. Here, micro means 10 to the power minus 6 meter. 1 micro means 10 to the power minus 6 meter. Okay? And in some other book also, if you read, actually this is a very small type of cell. So the variation you might get is 0.2 to 2 or 5 micrometer also in some textbook it is mentioned. Because these are the simple type of cell, right, which is very smaller in size. And this eukaryotic cell, comparatively, I will say it is larger in size. So here I will write, generally bigger in size, and the size will vary from 10 micrometer to 100 micrometer. This is the range of the size of the cell. And what I told about the nucleus, that also I will be listing in point form. Nuclear region is not surrounded by membrane. It is not surrounded by membrane, and it is called nucleoid. And in this case, nuclear material is surrounded by membrane, or I can write nuclear membrane. So this is about the nucleus part. There is genetic material. Now about the genetic material, which is present inside the nucleus, that is all spread in the cytoplasm also. I have shown you the diagram. In this case, prokaryotic cell, it have single chromosome. It have single chromosome, and in this case, is lineal. Circular, you can understand the structure. The DNA will be like this. And here the DNA is linear, means like the DNA we are having, it is parallel and linear in shape in case of eukaryotic cell. Now, what about the division? How the division will be taking place in such kind of cell? The prokaryotic cell or the eukaryotic cell? So here, the division is done by fission or budding. These are two processes through which the division of a cell can be done. In the simple type of cell, fission means one cell getting divided into two daughter cells. And budding means an extra outgrowth in the body of the parent or the cell. That outgrowth will be coming out, detaching from the parent and forming a new individual. So these type of divisions will be observed in case of prokaryotic cells, simple divisions. In case of eukaryotic cell, there is two major division taking place. The name of that division will be new for you, but you should be knowing. Division is by mitosis and meiosis. Division is by mitosis and meiosis. Cell division. So in short, if I have to tell you this to make you understand, mitosis, meiosis. See, our body completely, it is made up of some cell. So the body cell is called the somatic cell. Mitosis is the division which helps to recover from any injury or for the formation of the body cell. The gamete, that is the sperm and ova, or in case of the plant, pollen grain is having the male gamete and the ova in the pistil or the carpal part in the flower. So that part is getting developed, the gamete is getting developed with meiosis. So these are the two divisions which will take place in case of eukaryotic cell. Now, these are the prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. What will be the example of this? Example are the bacteria. So, archaebacteria, bacteria and cyanobacteria. Archaebacteria, archaebacteria, bacteria and cyanobacteria. These are the example of the prokaryotic cell. These organisms, these type of bacteria will be having the prokaryotic cell. This cyanobacteria is also known as the blue green algae, which was the earlier name of cyanobacteria. And the example of eukaryotic cell are, here we can list all the plants and animals, birds. There are many examples for the eukaryotic cell. We all are eukaryotes because we are having the cell that is eukaryotic cell. So now you know that there are organisms who are made up of prokaryotic cell and there are organisms made up of eukaryotic cell. Primitive cell and then eukaryotic cell is the advanced cell having a proper nucleus. And here one more thing you should remember, that I will list here, that you should never forget, or if I write a point also, 6 point as example. Yes. And the 7 cell organelle. So here we have understood about the two type of cell. Now, what about the cell shape and the size of the cell? Now we will be discussing. Do take a note of this and keep understanding what I am going to teach next. Because the shape and the size of the cell, it varies in the organism. Now you have understood the cell, right? The cell are two different types in the organism. And even the organism also are different according to the presence of the type of cell. So similar to that, there are the different shape of the organism cell, and the cell will perform different function. So now we will move to the next subtopic, that is cell shape and size. We all are made up of cell. I already have explained to you all this. Now, the cell shape and size, it is variable, I can write, or it varies in different organisms. The shape and the size of the cell, it is different for different organisms. Even in the organ also, inside our body, there are different cells, and our body is made up of cell. But the cells which is there, it's different. Now, you see, I'm moving my hand, right? So there are different muscles present in our body. There are the muscle which is called the smooth muscle. Smooth muscle. This is one cell. So this smooth muscle, or the cell I would say, you can see the shape. It is spindle shape. Spindle shape means tapering end. Means at the tip you can see these are joining. Spindle shape. Now there are certain cells which are also irregular in shape. Those irregular shaped cells are the nerve cells. If you see this cell, you see the shape. It is having a network-like structure at the top, right? And at the end it is elongated. This is a nerve cell. Then there is also one fat cell. This is a fat cell. Some other shape is, this is the ovum. The ovum is present inside the female body, having a nucleus. And the male gamete, it is having the head part, and then the neck part, and then the tail part. That is the sperm cell. Now, I have drawn here simply five diagrams just to tell you that the shape and the size of the organism is different. This diagram is to illustrate that the shape of the cell varies, and due to the variation, they are able to perform their respective functions. Each of them are having different function. This is a smooth cell, smooth muscle cell, and this cell will be present, let's say, in the esophagus or in the part where the movement of the substance has to take place. Then the nerve cell is there, fat cell, ovum and sperm cell is there. These are the different type of shapes of the cell which is present. And it is variable. The shape and the size of cells are variable. Now I will be listing you some of the examples for the cell which is the smallest one. See, like I am speaking here and you are able to listen, you are able to connect with me. That is because of the presence of nerve cell in the body. And even it has been observed that the nerve cell is having even 3 feet long. It is having a length of 3 feet long also. Such nerve cell also exists. It is the longest cell. Now coming to the largest known cell. What is the largest cell? That is the ostrich egg. The ostrich egg is the largest cell, and an average that how much centimeter this ostrich egg will be is 15. On an average, I can write it. On an average, length is 15 centimeter. So it will also vary. Somewhere you will get 18 centimeter, somewhere 15, but it is the average length what we see. And it is the largest cell which we can see from eyes, and that is the only single cell. And in humans, the largest cell will be the ovum, because female, we write like this, female ovum in humans. In humans are 20 times bigger than the sperm or the male germ cell. So there are different cells which are there, and the size you can see from here also that the size varies. All the cells or all the organisms will be not having the same type of cell or the same size of cell. The size, the shape of the cell, it also tells how the function will be there. On the basis of the function only, they are having all the differences in them. So these are some of the list of the organisms. Now, coming to the structure of cell. Till now we are understanding what is a cell, what is its size, what are the type of nucleus and the organisms. I told you, eukaryotic cell. If eukaryotic cell is present, that organism will be called as eukaryotes. Prokaryotic cell is present, the organism will be called eukaryotes. Okay, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Now moving to the next topic, that is structure of cell. Structure of cell. So simply the cell diagram what till now I was drawing. I will not tell now the elaborated diagram. You can go through the textbook also. Simply because I have to tell you in starting what is the structure. So simply this is the cell membrane. Then the nucleus having the genetic material. Okay. This is the fluid part, that is cytoplasm. And inside it there will be nucleolus. Yes, and this nucleolus, just now since I have told you the differences, the nucleolus will be only present in case of the eukaryotic cell, not in the prokaryotic cell. Okay. Now, cell membrane, this is the nucleus. I'm labeling it directly nucleus. The parts we will be reading it. Now, structure of cell when we talk, it is composed of mainly three things we will be listing, or consist of. Number one, it consists of cell membrane. Second, nucleus. And the third one, it consists of cytoplasm, which is the fluid part in the cell. So this structure you can see here also, and the cytoplasm will be having cell organelle. That cell organelle will be performing different functions. So we will be topic wise, like what are the part which is present. This is the cell membrane which you can see as the outer one, right? And in the plant, outside of that plasma membrane, even there is a cell wall which is present. So now, these in the structure of cell, these case of the animal, it is present outside, and in case of the, I can say in the animal it is outside, and in case of the plant there is a cell wall which will be present outside of that cell membrane. So here firstly I can write about the part that this is, okay, cell membrane is also called plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is the same name of the cell membrane. Cell membrane is called plasma membrane or plasma lemma. Both are same, fine. So it is the same thing. And it is thin, delicate. It is thin, delicate, and elastic. Plasma membrane is a living part of cell, and it will be present outside, I told you. So it is the outer covering in case of animals and in case of plants, cell wall is present outside and then plasma membrane. It is the outer covering in case of animal, and in case of plant, cell wall is present outside and then plasma membrane is present. This is about the cell membrane. Now, just to tell you what is the major function of it, a simplified diagram I will be drawing, because this plasma membrane is composed of lipid and proteins. This plasma membrane is composed of lipid and protein. So the lipid structure, it is like this. In the circular manner, the head part is arranged mission. function of the plasma membrane. I hope you have taken the notes of it and you have understood till here. Now, this was about the plasma membrane or the cell membrane. Now, moving to the function of the plasma membrane. So, the major function of the plasma membrane is it will be regulating the flow of substances inside and outside of cell. It will be regulating the flow of substances inside and outside of the cell, which is one of the important functions of plasma membrane, because you can just imagine if the cells are present and that is having the outer covering in animal as a plasma membrane, if it allows everything, the cell won't be able to work properly. So only the useful substances will be going inside, like the ions. I can tell sodium ions are there, potassium ions are there, right? So certain useful substances or certain things which is required by the cell, only those things are getting permission from the plasma membrane and moving inside or coming out. Now, second function of this plasma membrane is it will maintain the distinct composition. It will help in maintaining distinct composition of cell. Distinct composition of cell, it means that all the cells are having some component inside it and that composition will be unique to that cell. So that uniqueness, that distinct composition of the cell will be maintained with the help of the plasma membrane, right? So in today's class, what you have read is you have understood the difference or about the prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell, and then you have understood about the cell shape and size. It always varies depending on the function of the individual cell or the organism. And then the structure of cell, it is composed of the plasma membrane, nucleus and the cytoplasm. Then cell membrane, it is also called the plasma membrane. It is selectively permeable or semi-permeable membrane, which don't allow all the substance inside it or to go outside of it. Then the major function of it, that it will be regulating the flow of the substances inside and outside of the cell, and then it will help in maintaining distinct composition of the cell. So this is done with today's class. Do your assignment, which will be uploaded in the ERP.